I stopped by to tell somebody that you might be that woman with the issue of blood, or you might be blind Bartimaeus, but you got to have a determination in your heart that I'm going to get everything that God has for me. She had a mentality that nothing is going to stop me from getting a miracle from God. Is there somebody in here right now with that mindset that regardless of what I have to do to comply with a miracle, I'm willing to do it? If I gotta be called a dog, I'm willing to be called a dog. Fact is, I don't mind being called a dog by Jesus. I said by Jesus, because at the end of the day, he has the awesome ability to see you and I beyond our dog state. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, you about to evolve past the state that you are in. I declare unto you that God sees you and I beyond where we are. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. I guess I go on in and preach in here. I feel like really preaching in here. He can see us transform. He can see us deliver. He knows that we, praise God, won't quit on the process, even if he calls us a dog. Some of y'all got called a dog. You'll turn the other way. But this woman, she realized who she's dealing with. Sometimes when we come to God, we fail to recognize who we're dealing with. You got to have a greater understanding than what your eyes tell you. For we walk by faith and not by sight. You can call me a dog all you want, Jesus, because I believe that you have the ability to perform a radical change in my life. I believe that you can change me and rearrange me. But right now, I'm a dog. And it's all right because I know who my owner is. Somebody ought to give God a praise right now. Because a good dog know when they got a good owner. Lord have mercy. Y'all want to have some church with me? Lord have mercy. I may be a dog, but I got potential. Look at somebody and say, neighbor. Some of y'all won't say this because you don't want to claim what you are. But if you can believe this, say, neighbor, I know I'm a dog, but I got potential. Lord have mercy. Go on and back me up a little bit. Y'all ready to go to Pentecost? I know I'm a dog, but I got potential. I guess I'll go off script for a little while and talk about my dog I used to have. Got hit by a car named Spike. Well, when I went and got Spike, they said, Spike, he has potential. But right now, he's kind of rough. Train to run off on you. And there are a lot of us that God went straight to the pound and he brought you out. Look at somebody and say, neighbor, he brought me out. I was in a pound on my way to be euthanized, but God, he stopped by and picked up this pound puppy. I was supposed to be dead by now, but somehow when God saw me polluted in my own blood, I didn't have a license walking around without a car. But the Lord saw potential in me when nothing else could help. Pick me up, wash me off, comb my hair, gave me and a new lease on life. And what you see as a dog, God sees as potential. Yeah. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Yes. Oh yes. I may be a dog, but I got potential. And my faith tells me that although I was born outside of the covenant of God, although I don't have the right last name, although I was born without a silver spoon in my mouth, that God has the capacity to give a dog a bone. Go ahead and say, neighbor, God can give a dog a bone. Y'all trying to have church, because I sure feel like preaching. Somebody needs to know that God is able to supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory. You might be broke today, but that's nothing to your God. For the Father is rich in houses and land. The word says in Psalms 24 that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. I ain't afraid of being broke, because I know who owns the bank. I ain't afraid of being sick. I know who runs the hospital. Ain't afraid of being in trouble. I know the judge. Ow! I stop by to let somebody know you can be encouraged today. Because God will give every dog their day. Hallelujah. The problem with our society at large is we think we are already there. We think we've arrived. And praise God, don't have to beg for nothing. But I stop by to tell you, when it comes to you and I escaping the old and embracing the new, God has, praise God, a new life for everybody up in here. He has a new and living way for us to live our life by. And you know what I found out? If you want to embrace this new and living way, sometimes you gotta bark. Other times you gotta sniff. There are times you got to dig. There are times you gotta salivate. But I wanna know, is there anybody up in here?